Welcome back to East Texas Live. Joining us now virtually is Brian Livingston with Highway 80 Rescue Mission. Brian, congrats on being named the What Matters to You Matters to Us nonprofit for the month of January.
Thank you very much. We appreciate it.
Yeah, tell us a little bit about what this recognition means to y'all.
It's really incredible. We're completely donor-funded, community-funded. We realize that we can't do anything that we do without the support of the community. So to be recognized as meeting the needs that the community needs met, it's really a satisfying feeling to know that the community is behind us and they believe in what we do.
Which, if people are unfamiliar, tell us a little bit about what Highway 80 Rescue Mission does on a day-to-day basis.
Okay, well, I'll try to keep it short. We do a lot, actually. We have emergency shelters in Longview for women, children, and men who are experiencing homelessness. We have some addiction recovery programs, Christ-centered for both men and women here in Longview. And we also have a facility in Tyler where we have a men's program that's an addiction recovery discipleship program there. So our main goal is to help folks that are experiencing homelessness to get back on their feet, to get a job, to be able to budget, to secure housing, and to be self-sufficient.
Which definitely comes in handy, especially when we're seeing these chilling temperatures like we have this week. What's your capacity and how many people can you house every night?
Our emergency shelters in Longview have a capacity of about 200. We have another 40 beds in Tyler at our program facility, and we've been pushed. Just in Longview, we had close to that 200 people this weekend with the snow. So we don't ever turn anyone away. We'll put mats on the floor if we have to accommodate folks and get them out of the cold.
I'm sure you guys have had to do everything a little bit differently in the wake of the pandemic. Actually, can we pull up the picture of the award? I think I saw to my left that you guys have the masks on. Just kind of made me think about the pandemic. How have you guys had to shift operations to keep everybody safe and contain the spread of COVID, but still not turn anybody away?
Right. The biggest thing we've had to do is the biggest impact it's had on us is our volunteers. We haven't been able to have nearly as many volunteers come in and help, just trying to limit exposure. We've had to go occasionally to two different meal times, eat in shifts so we don't overcrowd the dining room. We tried to adjust our dorm rooms as best we could, and just very, very diligent with the cleaning, disinfectant, sanitizing, and making sure that we get people quarantined if they start showing any sort of signs or symptoms as quickly as possible, just to kind of limit the spread.
Other than food and shelter, what other services do y'all provide?
We provide some community services. This past Christmas, we did a gift giveaway, a drive-through gift giveaway, where we helped somewhere in the neighborhood of 800 children that may have not received Christmas gifts any other way. In non-COVID years, we do community dinners a few times a year, especially around holidays, Thanksgiving, Veterans Day, Easter. We'll do big community dinners and just invite folks in to just have a good meal and a time of fellowship. In the summer, we run a day camp for children, low-income and at-risk children in the community, just to kind of give them an option to participate in some almost a VBS-type environment that they may not have the opportunity to otherwise.
Brian, the whole point of this campaign, it's called What Matters to You Matters to Us. So before we let you go, I'd like to ask you this question. How can we help you guys continue to do what you do? What are your needs from us?
Well, as I mentioned before, we are completely community and donor funded, so financial donations are always welcome. Other things that we need donation wise are twin size bedding, towels, washcloths. Those sort of things don't last a whole lot of time when you're housing as many people as we do. And then whenever the COVID lets up, come volunteer. We love to have people come and help serve meals, tutor guys, help with the computer lab, lead chapel, tons of volunteer opportunities here at the mission once we're able to open that back up a little bit.
Brian, thank you so much for chatting with us this morning, and congratulations to y'all, well deserved.
Thank you very much. We appreciate it.